Hey, CLF family, hope you are doing well. I just want to let you know that your pastors are thinking of you. We are missing you. We are praying for you. We love you. And you know what? We are just believing that as you are pressing into Jesus in this season right now, that He is leading your life, that He's guiding you, that He's bringing peace over your household, over every area of your life right now. Because, you know, we are in a world that is just different than we've ever experienced before. We are in times right now where there is so many devices, there are so many unknowns, there is so much evil, there is so much propaganda, there are so many lies. There's just so much that we are having to wade through and try to figure out. And yet Jesus hasn't changed, and He saw all this coming. And so I am just praying that you are just turning to Him with every area of your heart and your life, and that He is showing Himself so strong. You know, Kristen and I just got back from a trip to Maryland to visit her family. We had a great visit, but you know, we had to take this road trip there and a road trip back. And our road trip, which is usually so much fun, and we had good road trips, but it was so different this time than normal. Because we would come into a new state, and if we'd stop for gas or stop at some other establishment or something, we would have to first check the door as we're entering in to see what are the policies. What does it look like here in this state or in this county or whatever? You know, and every place is different on what you could do and couldn't do and what they required of you. And that is just kind of like our reality right now, isn't it? There are so many things that once were very common and normal, and we didn't have to think about it. And now, you know, stuff that once was simple seems burdensome and heavy. Things that once were very quick and convenient become inconvenient now because of the time we live in and because of COVID. And so, you know what? We have all kind of formed an opinion on how we are dealing with all of this personally. Some of us take it very seriously. Some don't think it's that big of a deal. And we all have different opinions that are kind of formed, and they have been structured based on what we've experienced and how COVID has affected us, how it's affected our loved ones, how it's affected the people that are close to us, and, you know, our workplaces and our kids going to school, and, you know, maybe what we've heard and what we've listened to in the news, and, you know, what we believe is right and what we believe is wrong, and truth and lies. And, you know, we all kind of are formulating an opinion and trying to figure out where we stand with all this, right? And so the thing is, our opinion is probably different than the next person. In fact, as a pastor, it's been eye-opening to me as I've talked to different people. And one person will blow it off, like downplay it, like this is just not a big deal what's going on right now at all, and it's all being blown out of proportion. And then the next person I talk to gives me a heartfelt story about how COVID has directly affected them and how they've lost loved ones and how their life will never be the same, you know? And so we all are living in the same time, but we're all being affected differently. And so what I want to talk about real quick before I roll out and highlight some of the policies that we have at CLF as we begin to meet again and come together for live services. I don't just want to give you some policies, because we're getting policies from everywhere. We're getting policies from our government. We're getting policies from schools. We're getting policies from places of business. You know, I mean, there's so much to divide us and so much to think about, but I want you to get our heart at CLF here of why we decided to take the steps that we're taking when we meet in person. Because our desire is that if we're gonna err, we're gonna err on the side of safety, of caution, and of grace for everybody and where they're at with all of this. And, you know, actually Paul, in the book of Romans, he addresses a church that is facing a division in the church over an issue of whether they should eat meat or not, because one group of the church says, well, you know what? We have liberty to eat whatever we want and it's not gonna affect me. And then the other side of the church is saying, well, the meat that you're eating is being offered to idols And we have a strong conviction that it is wrong to eat that meat. And so there's like this difference of opinion that's actually bringing division, condemnation, bringing all kinds of issues into the church. And Paul gets beyond the surface issue and goes down to the heart level issue of the kingdom in dealing with this thing going on in the church. So in Romans 14, verse 15 through 19, it says this. Paul says, "If another believer is distressed by what you eat, you're not acting in love if you eat it. Don't let your eating ruin someone for whom Christ died, and then you will not be criticized for doing something you believe is good. For the kingdom of God is not a matter of what we eat or drink, but of living a life of goodness and peace and joy in the Holy Spirit. If you serve Christ with this attitude, you will please God, and others will approve of you too. So then, let us aim for harmony in the church and try to build each other up." And Paul goes on and he says, "Look, if anything I eat is going to cause a brother or a sister to stumble, I'm not going to eat it." And so, you know, here's the deal. As a leadership, we're making decisions on what our policy is going to be, but we're saying, you know, if a COVID case came up and somebody said, "Yeah, I'm positive," and we alert the whole church of that somebody tested positive, we want to be able to say without a shadow of a doubt, without hesitation, that we did everything in our power, everything in our ability, everything in our decision-making to make sure that we kept everyone as safe as possible, that we took every precaution to prevent anyone from getting this virus from anyone else in one of our services. That's it. Because we care and we love our people. We are shepherds over a flock of people that we absolutely adore and care about, and we have your protection and safety at the forefront and utmost responsibility that we carry. We want to make sure that everybody is safe. And so if you feel comfortable, we want as many people as possible to come out to our live services on Sunday. But if you don't feel ready yet, if maybe you're in quarantine, if you have symptoms, you know, or whatever the case may be, well, we are doing everything we can to make our online experience as good and as high quality as possible to continue to do that so you can join in. But you know what? If you say you're ready and you know, maybe you're here last week or on Father's Day and you're planning on coming back or you're kind of on the edge and you're thinking of coming back, we want you to know that we are putting the policies in place to make sure that everybody stays as safe as possible. And so I want to highlight just a couple things that we've changed since our Father's Day service. And the first one is that we are just asking that everyone comes into service with a mask and that they wear the mask throughout our service. Our services are shortened, you know, to about an hour. And then once we dismiss, we're going to be dismissing from the back of the sanctuary to the front. And we ask that once you're dismissed and you come through the sanctuary, to head straight outside where you can continue to fellowship. When you're first showing up and you're having ushers direct you to a seat, you know, we're asking that just families or whoever you came with that you sit together, that, you know, if you're waiting to be seated, that you socially distance. And so we have marks on the floor, X's, where you can kind of see where 6 feet is to help you social distance. But you know what, the most important thing, and what I just want to share as my heart right now is, and on behalf of the pastors here at CLF, is that we are to love each other and prefer one another. Like Pastor Jeff said on Sunday, to practice the fruit of the Spirit, which is love and joy and peace and patience and kindness and, you know, all the fruit. But we do that by not just looking at maybe how wearing a mask affects us, but how wearing a mask is helping and preventing, and it's providing a place of safety for everyone else. We're thinking of others, not just of ourselves. And so, hope you have a great week. Look forward to seeing you soon. God bless.